In this video, I'll show you what differences there are between Google Scholar and the bibliographic databases of the UVA Library. Google. We all know it. However convenient it may be, if you'd want to use Google to search very specific scientific information, you'll quickly run into problems. For situations like these, Google has developed its own solution, the search engine Google Scholar. This lets you search scientific articles. The UVA Library is subscribed to dozens of databases where you can find academic publications just like you would through Google Scholar. But what is the advantage of having various databases? Or do they overlap? The differences become apparent when you compare two aspects, content and usage. We'll start with content. Databases allow for a very targeted search within a specific discipline. They are put together by subject specialists who have inventoried the most important publications within one discipline or field of study. An example of this is the MLA International Bibliography. Here you can find sources relating to various languages and literatures, but nothing about information technology or physics. And that's one of the main differences between databases and Google Scholar. In Google Scholar, you cannot search within a specific discipline or filter your search results accordingly. Database publishers often hire subject specialists or bibliographers. They take care of the proper selection of relevant information sources that constitute a database. That's not how Google Scholar works. The content on Google Scholar is mainly based on what scientific information can be found online. For databases, bibliographers who have received specialist training take care that they consistently allocate subject descriptions. Google Scholar adopts the descriptions available online from institutes, universities, and scientists. As you might imagine, this information could be missing or outdated at times. Database contents are almost always guaranteed, by which I mean what you find today, you'll usually find again tomorrow, or in a year's time. In Google Scholar, the content you find earlier isn't always available indefinitely. For instance, when a publisher retracts a publication, all of this means you can find reliable and relevant sources for a specific subject field faster and more efficiently through a database, while often gaining a more complete overview. But what about usage? Using Google Scholar is very simple. Just like in Google Search, you enter a query to immediately and almost always receive a number of results. As the search options tend to be quite elaborate for databases, you need to be mindful of what to enter where as soon as you set out. But on the other hand, you can target your search in various ways, as the database contains a lot of options to filter your results. Google Scholar doesn't offer many of these options. For example, this is a search performed in both Google Scholar and PsycInfo. In PsycInfo, you can narrow down by subject. That's not possible in Google Scholar. As you see, there are differences between Google Scholar and databases, both in terms of the contents and the way they're used. As for the content, there's definitely some overlap, but databases often hold some added value when you're looking for relevant literature about your specific subject. Do you still have questions about which databases are most suited for your research? Ask the information specialist responsible for your discipline, or submit them via Ask the Library.